Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Shivani Chandra, postgraduate resident in the Department of Radio Diagnosis at Atal Bihari Vajpayee Institute of Medical Sciences and Dr. RML Hospital, New Delhi. I'll be presenting my paper on the topic of role of multi-detector computed tomography in evaluation of pancreatic neoplasms. MDCT is touted as the main workhorse for the evaluation of pancreatic tumors. Being quick and cost-effective, it also allows for multiphasic imaging, enabling excellent characterization of the mass lesion. It provides information about the extent, vascular infiltration, and sites of metastasis, all of which are crucial determinants for resectability. In this review, we discuss the imaging findings of cystic as well as solid pancreatic tumors using MDCT. The aim of the study is to characterize pancreatic neoplasms using MDCT. This was a cross-sectional observational study conducted at Atal Bihari Vajpayee Institute of Medical Sciences and Dr. RML Hospital. The scans were performed on Siemens Somatom Definition Flash 128 slice scanner in the Department of Radio Diagnosis. The phases used were non-contrast, earlier arterial, pancreatic, and delayed portal venous using rapid contrast agent administration at 3 to 5 milliliters per second, oral administration of 500 to 700 milliliters of water approximately 30 minutes before imaging time was also done. A total of 40 patients were included, out of which 55% demonstrated solid pancreatic lesions and 45% had cystic pancreatic neoplasms. Out of the solid neoplasms, 77% were pancreatic adenocarcinomas, 9% were metastatic deposits, 9% were neuroendocrine tumors, and one case was pancreatic lymphoma. In the remaining cystic group of lesions, 44% comprised of IPMNs, 27% comprised of mucinous cyst adenomas, and another 27% were of serous cyst adenomas. Coming to the individual cases, this was a case of pancreatic adenocarcinoma. Here we can see a heterogeneous hypodense mass in the pancreatic head with atrophy of the pancreatic tail and a dilated MPD. There is associated IHBRD. In inset 1, we can see that there is obliteration of the splenocortical confluence. And in inset 2, we see that there is infiltration into the D2 segment of the duodenum. This was a case of pancreatic neuroendocrine tumor, where we can see a hypervascular enhancing mass in the arterial phase in the pancreatic neck. This was also associated with multiple hypervascular enhancing lesions in the liver, as well as a paracaval lymph node metastatic deposit. This was a case of a pancreatic metastasis from a lung primary. Here we can see a heterogeneously enhancing mass lesion in the right lung, along with a hypovascular rounded metastatic deposit in the pancreatic body. This was a case of pancreatic lymphoma, where we can see multiple round hypoattenuating masses seen in the pancreatic body and tail. Bilateral kidneys show evidence of multiple hypo-enhancing masses with enlarged aortocaval and para-aortic lymph node masses. This was a case of pancreatic IPMN. In here, we can see a cystic attenuation lesion in the pancreatic uncinate process, which is communicating with the main pancreatic duct. These findings are suggestive of a side branch IPMN. This was a case of pancreatic mucinous cyst adenoma, where we can see a unilocular cystic lesion in the pancreatic uncinate process and the head region, and there is no communication with the MPD. This was a case of pancreatic serous cyst adenoma, where we can see a multilobulated microcystic lesion in the pancreatic head, and there is no obvious communication to the main pancreatic duct. The age group mostly affected by pancreatic mass lesions in this study was 50 to 75 years, which is in accordance with the findings of Jamath et al., who reported that these were uncommon below the age of 40 years. Pancreatic neoplastic lesions were more common in males, and out of the solid pancreatic neoplasms, the most common entity was a pancreatic adenocarcinoma, comprising 77% of the solid neoplasms. Out of the cystic pancreatic neoplasms, the most common entity was IPMN, which comprised of 44% of the cystic neoplasms. Coming to the MDCT imaging findings in each case, pancreatic adenomas present as poorly marginated hyperenhancing masses, mostly located in the head and ancinate process. They show the double duct sign, which is dilatation of the MPD as well as the CBD, signs of vascular encasement and spread to adjacent organs. Pancreatic neuroendocrine tumors are hypervascular. They present as homogeneous masses if they are small and heterogeneous and cystic masses if large. They displace rather than invading vessels. Pancreatic lymphomas present as hypo-enhancing homogeneous tumors with associated peripancreatic lymph nodal enlargement, and they encase rather than invade vessels. Pancreatic metastases have a variable appearance and they depend on the primary. Commonly arising from renal cell carcinomas, melanomas, lung carcinomas, and breast carcinoma. In the cystic pancreatic neoplasms, pancreatic IPMN presents as a cystic lesion which communicates with the MPD, mostly located in the pancreatic head, and they may be multifocal. Pancreatic mucinocystic neoplasms present as macrocystic masses with thick walls and peripheral mucal calcifications, typically showing no communication with the MPD, mostly located in the pancreatic body and the tail. Pancreatic serocystic neoplasms present as microcystic lobulated masses, and they have no communication with MPD. Sometimes they show a central scar with calcification, which allows for a more specific diagnosis. Thus, MDCT plays a central role in the differential diagnosis of pancreatic neoplasms. It can characterize lesions as solid or cystic and determine the extent of vascularity. Further, it can determine the extent of the lesion and demonstrate sites of metastasis and vascular involvement, thus enabling radiologists to play pivotal roles in deciding the lines of management and in determining patient prognosis. These are my references. Thank you.